Imagine a world where everything you thought you knew about our solar system was turned on its head, where the distant icy realm of Pluto harbors on a secret so profound it could rewrite the cosmos narratives we've held dear for centuries. Whispered among the corridors of power and science, a chilling revelation emerges. Pluto, the outcast, the dwarf planet once stripped of its planetary crown, is now on a collision course with Neptune. This isn't just a story of cosmic ballet, it's a ticking time bomb, a potential cataclysm waiting to unleash chaos in the serene outer reaches of our solar system. What if everything we've been told about the stability of our planetary neighborhood is just the tip of the iceberg? Stay with us as we peel back the layers of this cosmic conspiracy, diving deep into the shadows of space where the future of two worlds hang in the balance. Are you ready to question everything? Welcome to the edge of discovery, where the fate of planets and the truths we take for granted are about to collide. Initially, the solar system was said to comprise 9 planets, among which Pluto was, until scientists came up with factual evidence to prove Pluto was not a planet, but a space object. In the Big Bang Theory, the popular character Sheldon Cooper has said more than once that Neil deGrasse Tyson single-handedly kicked Pluto out of the solar system. But is this a fact or a mere assumption? It would seem this is an exaggeration, but Neil deGrasse is not entirely blameless. Tyson did play a controversial role in the demotion of Pluto. In the early 20th century, some investigators became interested in the possibility that there was a planet in the solar system that was farther than Neptune. One of them was Dr. Percival Lowell, who created a research program in 1906 that lasted until he died in 1916. Using equipment that is too hard to write about, but you would most likely want to read about, Dr. Lowell searched for the elusive planet X, which became a subject of a paper he published in 1915. Unfortunately, Dr. Lowell died the following year, and the research took a 13-year-old hiatus. Fortunately, the research resumed in 1929, and in 1930, astronomer Clyde Tombaugh finally discovered what would later be designated as Pluto, Dr. Lowell's planet, the 9th planet of the solar system. However, starting in 1992, questionable claims that Pluto may not be a planet at all started gaining attention. According to some scientists, Pluto was just one of the many celestial bodies on the Kuiper Belt, a region of the solar system beyond the orbit of Neptune, believed to contain many asteroids, comets, and other small bodies made largely of ice. The scientific community was polarized by these findings. Meanwhile, in 1996, the renowned astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson became director of the Hayden Planetarium at the American Museum of Natural History in New York City, and the planetarium had to close down for some reason. But in the year 2000, Hayden Planetarium opened its doors again to the public, and a year later, the New York Times published a story that someone noticed there were only 8 planets in the solar system exhibits in the planetarium. A huge controversy followed, and obviously, this did not come as a surprise. Neil deGrasse Tyson wrote a letter in response to the controversial claims where he explained the absence of Pluto and rebuked the New York Times for implying that Hayden Planetarium was alone in taking the position that Pluto was not the 9th planet of our solar system. They gave 3 criteria about what makes a planet a planet. According to them, a planet is a celestial body that firstly is in orbit around the sun, secondly has sufficient mass for its self-gravity to overcome rigid body forces so that it assumes a hydrostatic equilibrium shape, and thirdly has cleared the neighborhood around its orbit. Now, what does the last phrase, clear the neighborhood, mean? Does it mean what a planet should do to clear the neighbor around its orbit or make a neighborhood watch? Well, no, it simply means that it has to be a big bully and get rid of any other orbiting objects apart from its satellite around it. In more scientific words, it has to become gravitationally dominant and there are no bodies of comparable size other than its own satellite or those otherwise under its gravitational influence. Members of the International Astronomical Union took a vote and resolved that Pluto did not satisfy the third criterion and was therefore not a planet but a dwarf planet. The definition and the resolution were met with a fierce backlash from other scientific community members, with some starting a petition for reinstatement of Pluto's classification as a planet. While Neil deGrasse did not single-handedly kick Pluto out of the solar system, he describes himself as an accessory to the decision made by the International Astronomical Union in 2006 to degrade Pluto from being a planet to a dwarf planet. When Pluto was officially demoted from planet to dwarf planet in 2006, you would expect a clapback, particularly from scientists who fancy Pluto. Neil deGrasse, the man at the forefront of this decision, faced a lot of criticism as a result of that decision. He was widely blamed for what many saw as a shabby treatment of America's beloved planet. Tyson started noticing that Pluto was different from other planets in the 1990s. At the time, other ice bodies that were similar to Pluto were discovered in the outer solar system. Those bodies were also like Pluto in another way. They crossed orbits. He added that Pluto was the only planet whose orbit crossed the orbit of another planet. Tyson said, "It's kind of misbehaving if you think in those terms." When Tyson put together an exhibit showing the relative size of planets at the Hayden Planetarium in 2000, he decided not to include Pluto. Tyson stated that they wanted to be sure that the exhibit had high shelf life and added that the exhibit was an investment, so he had to look carefully at what was going on in the solar system. This led him to organize the solar system as like properties rather than an enumeration of cosmic objects, as it was so commonly taught in school. Other astrophysicists said Tyson was off base. Museum visitors noticed Pluto's omission from the solar system and sent spiteful letters. And when it was finally reported in the New York Times on January 2001, Tyson said he received a new wave of hate mail. Although critics viewed the omission as a demotion for Pluto, Tyson said he viewed it as a new swath of real estate in the outer solar system called the Kuiper Belt and comets. Pluto was, in fact, the first discovered object in the Kuiper Belt rather than the ninth planet. Tyson said there is no stigma attached to being labeled a dwarf planet. In fact, he thinks Pluto is a comet because it is mostly ice by volume. If you slid Pluto to where Earth is right now, heat from the sun would probably evaporate the ice and it would grow a tail. In order to counter the controversial opinion of critics and the general public, Tyson said, "I think Pluto is happier in its current classification. We didn't lose a planet, we gained the Kuiper Belt, and now Pluto is one of the kings of the Kuiper Belt. Pluto is just fine." It would seem like some scientists are just not convinced about kicking Pluto out of the solar system. Scientists from the New Horizon mission to Pluto are making their case that the dwarf planet should be considered a planet again. Science popularizer and Cosmo host Neil deGrasse came out vehemently against them on a late-night TV show. While speaking on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert, Tyson pointed out that Pluto's orbit crosses Neptune's from time to time, and that's no kind of behavior for a planet. Remember, in 2006, the International Astronomical Union agreed that to be considered a planet, an object would have to orbit the sun, be round, and be large enough to clear the local neighborhood of debris, a definition that excluded Pluto. This definition came under renewed scrutiny after the New Horizons 2015 flyby of Pluto revealed a world with vast mountains and other surprising terrain for such a small world. However, John Hopkins PhD student named Kirby Runyon, who worked closely with the team, offered a new definition of planethood. In the proposal, he stated that they define a planet as a substellar mass body that has never undergone nuclear fusion and has enough gravitational heft to maintain a roughly round shape, even if it bulges at the equator because of a three-way squeeze of forces created by its gravity and the influence of both the sun and a nearby larger planet. Unlike the International Astronomical Union's definition, this new proposal makes no mention of the planet's surroundings being cleared. Alan Stern, New Horizons principal investigator, said their definition of planet, if applied strictly, would not even apply to Earth, Jupiter, Mars, and Neptune, which share their orbits with asteroids. Under Runyon's definition, there would be roughly 110 planets in our solar system instead of the current 8. In the statement, he said that would be an excellent way to engage the public in exploration, as objects defined as planets would naturally carry more weight and draw additional interest. Pluto's official status change came only after a flurry of discoveries of similarly sized bodies, most by California Institute of Technology astronomer Mike Brown. With Pluto spending about 20 years of its 248-year orbit within the orbit of Neptune, you might expect that at some point, the two worlds could collapse in a catastrophic event. However, Pluto and Neptune never actually passed through the same three-dimensional point in space because Pluto's elliptical orbit is tilted 17 degrees to the ecliptic. But what about the future? It would seem that Pluto's orbit experiences two effects that keep the dwarf planet safe. Its point of closest approach to the sun oscillates in the vertical direction and also in the radial direction. These orbital effects are latitudinal libration and azimuthal libration. What could these two effects possibly mean, and what are the implications on Pluto? Latitudinal libration always puts Pluto high above Neptune's orbit when they are in close proximity to each other. On the other hand, azimuthal libration ensures that Pluto never crosses Neptune's orbit within 90 degrees of the ice giant. The properties are the consequences of a so-called orbital resonance between the two worlds. Pluto and Neptune are locked in a 3-to-2 orbital resonance. This implies that for every three trips Neptune makes around the sun, Pluto orbits twice. And if they start getting out of sync, their mutual gravitational pull nudges them back into a finely choreographed dance. Hence, Pluto and Neptune never come within about 16 astronomical units of one another. Bear in mind that one astronomical unit is the average Earth-Sun distance. Despite these scientific facts, in the 1980s, numerical simulations suggested that Pluto's orbit was technically chaotic. For billions of years, scientific claims suggest that Pluto would either collide with another world or be rejected from the solar system entirely. However, in a paper published on March 31st, 2022, titled Pluto Near the Edge of Chaos, researchers explored why Pluto's orbit has ultimately remained stable over the solar system's lifetime. To arrive at this conclusion, they ran a series of simulations of our solar system that tracked the evolution of Pluto's orbit over 4.5 billion years. Somewhat surprisingly, Uranus seems to push the dwarf planet in a chaotic orbit. But while Neptune provided the greatest contributions to stabilizing Pluto's azimuthal liberation, the giant planet did not significantly influence the strength of Pluto's latitudinal liberation. Instead, Jupiter seemed to be the most responsible for this particular collision avoidance around Pluto's orbit. So as long as our solar system maintains the orbital status quo, we should not expect any planetary fireworks. The debate on Pluto's planet status still persists, with researchers coming up with new findings. In addition to this, the speculated catastrophic event that involves Pluto clashing with Neptune is still an ongoing subject of debate among scientists. Which scientific finding did you find most interesting? How Pluto was kicked out of the solar system? Tyson's opinion on Pluto? The proposal for Pluto to be a planet? Or the catastrophic solar fireworks that entail Pluto clashing into Neptune? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe to the channel for more videos. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.